What's up guys, Eric Psykik here, and today I want to show you guys Tibialyzer. If you watch all of my videos, you probably know what Tibialyzer is by now, but if you haven't heard of it, Tibialyzer is basically a program that analyzes your server log and makes the data easier to read while also notifying you of potential things you might not want to miss. It also has a lot of other features too, which will all be explained in this video. So to start off, I'll teach you how to download Tibialyzer and get it up and running. If you already have Tibialyzer and just want to see the different things you can do with it, click here to skip ahead. Alright, so to download Tibialyzer, head over to the link in the description of this video, which is github.com/mithrin/tibialyzer. Do not ever download Tibialyzer from anywhere else unless you see a future annotation in this video. If you're not on GitHub or any other website I specify in this video, do not download Tibialyzer. GitHub is the only safe place to download it from currently. Once on GitHub, click this little tag that says Releases. Click on Tibialyzer 1.3.0, or whatever version is the latest, then scroll down to the bottom of the page where it says Downloads. Click on the zip file. So once you have downloaded the zip file, extract its contents onto your desktop, run the installer, and once that's done, you can open Tibialyzer. Before you get started, make sure to check all of the boxes in your console settings located in the option menus in-game. This is how Tibialyzer gets all of its data. Now that you've got Tibialyzer up and running, it's time to see all the sweet things it can do. So first off, make sure you add your characters to your Tibialyzer safe list so their commands will be read. This is to prevent other Tibialyzer users from messing with yours by typing commands in-game. Simply click inside the box under the main menu, type your character's name, and then hit enter. Two of my favorite features of Tibialyzer are the summary window and loot notifications. The summary window is a medium-sized box that shows you your loot value, waste value, calculated profit, experience gain, time hunted, calculated experience per hour, supplies used, and monsters killed. By default, the summary window stays open for 30 seconds, but if you're like me and want to see what your hunt looks like in real time, simply head over to the notifications tab, find the summary window, and drag the slider to infinite. If you don't like where the summary window is positioned, or any window in Tibialyzer for that matter, you can change their position by playing with the numbers up in the top right corner. I like to position mine on the top left anchor, X30, Y100, but if you prefer your summary window somewhere else, you can move it to your liking. To close the summary window or any Tibialyzer window, all you have to do is click in the gray area at the top. Every bolt you shoot, every potion you drink, every single gold coin dropped by a monster is recorded and updated instantly in the summary window. Some people report that their Tibialyzer doesn't always count their ammo used. This could be due to not having all of the boxes checked in the options menu. Another person told me they think you need to hotkey the ammo for Tibialyzer to read it. I'm not sure exactly how to fix the problem, but I'll throw an annotation in here if I figure it out, since my Tibialyzer counts ammo just fine as you've seen in my Paladin videos. I found that the experience counter on Tibialyzer is a little different than Tibiacast, but even with Tibiacast going down, it will be a good replacement. If I hunt the old fortress for example, Tibialyzer will jump between 1.8 and 2.1 kk an hour throughout the hunt, but recently I hunted there for an hour straight and I gained 2 million experience, so it's still pretty accurate. But I just wanted to make note of that, so in future videos of mine, if you're off by 100 to 200k experience, it could just be the calculator and value I'm reporting, and not that you're actually hunting the spawn wrong. To get accurate information for a hunt, you'll probably want to clear your summary window before you start. To do this, type reset at. Tibialyzer constantly scans your server log as you hunt to show the information, and this is dependent on your scanning speed. The higher you set your scanning speed, the more CPU Tibialyzer will use. I have mine set to the default, which is in the middle, and my Tibialyzer works just fine, so any faster probably won't hurt, but I'd be careful lowering the scanning speed or you could be backtracking to get drops that don't show up instantly. So I mentioned Tibialyzer has loot notifications as well. By default, any item worth over 2,000 gold will pop up, but I changed that number to 1,000 and you can set the number to anything you like in the pop-ups tab. Sometimes you'll be farming for an item, let's say you want small rubies for house decoration, but their value is not quite 2,000 or 1,000 gold. To make a notification appear without changing the item's value, just type in small ruby on the pop-up items list and no matter what the value is, you'll receive a notification. You can do this with any item, so if you're farming for pieces to an outfit, this can be really handy. There's also a little clipboard icon in loot notifications. If you click this, the loot message will be instantly copied and you can paste it, which makes sharing rare drops with people easy. Level advancements can also be automatically added to clipboard and screenshotted too. Just head over to the screenshots tab and tick whichever boxes you'd like screenshots saved of. So Mithrin plays on Unaterra, and Tibialyzer's default item values are probably based on his world, or at least optional PvP, but if you play on a PvP server like me, or another world that has a slightly different economy, you can change every item's value to fit your world's prices and get a more accurate loot value from your hunt. For example, on my world, stone skin amulets are worth 5k, but I believe Tibialyzer's default value is 500 GP, which is the price when you sell them to NPC. So to change this value, all you have to do is shift click or look at the amulet, then click the arrows to change its value. And this goes for any item. It'll take some time to personalize your Tibialyzer totally, but once you do, it'll calculate your profit nicely. You can also bring up items you can't currently look at by typing item at item name. While you're in there changing the value of an item, you can also check this box if you don't want your Tibialyzer to pick the item up at all. So on my main, for example, I usually uncheck this box for gold coins because I never pick them up. All of the commands for Tibialyzer are pretty simple. There's pretty much a category for everything, followed by the at symbol, and then the individual name. You can find all of the commands under the Help tab here. They can be pretty handy for looking stuff up quick, like say you want a stuffed toad. You type in item at stuffed toad, and now you can see it's a very rare drop off of a witch and what Tibialyzer values it at. Say you're trying to stock up for the August dishes. If you type in item at lemon, you can see all of the NPCs that sell lemons. Item at bar of chocolate, and now you know Nightmare Scions drop bars of chocolate. Rarely. Good luck. Tibialyzer also comes with a HUD like the Flash client, so if you like those curved health and mana bars, you can still use them. You can also turn on different square bars, a portrait like WoW, and even a health list, which I just found out about. Apparently you can put the health of different players into the list and be able to see everyone's health at the same time, which makes COing a whole lot easier. You can even attach an image for each player, so as you can see, I put a little picture of myself. I don't know what happens if people are too far away, but I think I could actually see myself healing for the first time ever thanks to this. So those are pretty much the main features of Tibialyzer that I like to use. There are many other things you can do with the program, so take a look around through all the menus and explore all of its features. One other thing I like to use Tibialyzer for is checking where loot sells. You can either look at an item or bring it up with the item command and you'll see what NPC every item sells to and for how much. This is also really handy for checking where Rashid is every day. Just bring up an item that sells to Rashid or type NPC at Rashid and Tibialyzer will show you where he is that day. I've used this program every day since I've downloaded it, and it's a lifesaver. Having to read the server log while you hunt was just plain annoying, and I was always going back and forth from having the damage on and off so I could see what people were getting hit by in PvP, but now I don't have to worry about that anymore. One thing to note though is if you're really looking for an item, I would put it on the exception list to be 100% safe. I've only ever seen Tibialyzer miss two drops. One was a tower shield from a lizard Hygar, which I think popped up eventually, so it could have just been lag or something, and the other was a terror rod from a lizard snake charmer. For some reason, it didn't pick up the terror rod twice, so that could just be a minor bug. When I was farming for my tin key, I made sure the value was over 1k, Tibialyzer was picking it up, and that it was on the exception list. One last thing to end this video, whenever Tibialyzer updates, all you have to do is click this button that says download new memory addresses and your Tibialyzer will work with the latest version of Tibia. You have to wait for Mithrin himself to update the new addresses though, so if you try to update it right after server save, it's obviously not going to work. If for any reason your Tibialyzer resets and you lose your settings, you can also get them back from previous versions by selecting your old Tibialyzer directory. Alright guys, that's the gist of Tibialyzer. I have to give a big thanks to Mithrin for this program and the fact that he made this completely free for everyone to use and updates it regularly. He didn't ask me to, but I have to plug his donation page in here. If you love this program as much as I do and have some money to spare, consider donating to Mithrin for his hard work. I'm sure he's going to have to put in a lot of time to get Tibialyzer to work with Tibia 11, and also every future update that comes to Tibia. I'll put the link to his donation page in the description if you're interested, next to a link of his own Tibialyzer video in case you want some more information on how the program works. Hopefully this video clears up any confusion on the program, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll be happy to answer them to the best of my knowledge. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.